you can leave it. Thank you. You can leave it.
No, I can speak to you, actually.
I'm sorry?
I need to speak to you. I don't think you realize where they're coming from, so I need to speak to you.
Where what's coming from?
Where the food you ordered is coming from. I don't think you realize the distance that it's come from, because then you would never actually have given what you give. So I think you can come and see face-to-face. Because I drove 40 minutes. I drove 40 minutes, and it was extremely far, and I got it to you early. So I don't think you realize where you work from.
I don't understand.
From
where?
From the restaurant that you ordered from. Do you realize how far it is? Do you realize you ordered from Carmack and you're in Smithtown?
That's a 15, 20 minute drive.
It's not. You need to try to drive it. I just drove it. It's 40 minutes. It's 12 and a half miles. So I don't think you realize how far it is.
So why do you accept the pickup if you think it's that far?
They don't let us know how far. So I think you need to adjust your tip to make it right.
How much is the tip?
You gave an $8 tip.
What the hell are you looking for? I gave an $8.
Okay, I'm going to bring the food back. I'm going to bring the food back. Okay.
Okay. Is she fucking kidding?
$8? That's a lot.
40 minutes it took her to get her?
Power to the people, we back to do maintenance. Yeah, we gonna rock like crack when it came in. And you gonna love it. This is Macon's Minute. I'm your host, Tony Anthony Macon, here to entertain and somewhat enlighten you. Got a few things to talk about today, as you may have seen the entering video. Quite hilarious. A Long Island delivery driver is upset with an $8 tip.
How much? $8. These niggas talking about $8.
Yeah, let's get into this. Let's talk about this. Are you stimulated? Have you got your stimmy yet? I got my stimmy. Maybe this woman didn't get her stimmy. She's counting every penny she needs right now. Round of applause for this woman. Yeah. I ain't never mad at a woman that is about her Skrilla. Never mad at that. Never mad at a woman who's about her money. And yeah, this situation was quite crazy. Don't get me wrong. She was definitely wrong. She demanded. She wanted to talk to this man face to face about the $8 tip.
They talk about $8. They talk about.
Take a let's kind of analyze this a bit and take a like a gander at like some of the things that like stick out. She said it was a 40-minute drive, right? And apparently they don't get the distance of how long of a drive it is before they accept it. That's what she sounded like. She said she didn't know the distance of the drive up front. However, I did look online, and I was able to come up with a few things, someone actually posted the length of drive from point A to point B. And out of three different routes, the max is 14 minutes. The least was 11 minutes. I mean, 11-minute drive, 14-minute drive. Was $8 enough? or on her, on her, the argument on her behalf. Was that 40 minutes? Maybe was it traffic involved? Listen, man, is $8 is it a sufficient tip for anyone? And I looked at the bag, looked at the amount of stuff that was in that bag. It just didn't look like it was a huge bag. I don't know if like maybe that was there was lobster tails in there and maybe steak. Was this, you know, was this a high-end restaurant? Even if so, when you tip for delivery service, do you tip for the delivery or do you tip based on the bill? Like for me, if I order a pizza and the pizza comes, if the total amount of pizza comes with like 30 something bucks, I usually just tip five just because if it came to $40, I would tip five. If it came to 50, I would tip five. I would not tip based off of if I was actually sitting in the restaurant. So is $8 enough for a drive that is debatably 11 to 40 minutes, right? I would think $8 would be enough because I'm pretty sure that there was a delivery fee as well. I think this lady more so was just coming from a place of privilege, entitlement. She came across Karen-esque. She seemed like, and I'm speculating. Why not? But she seemed like a woman who was out of her element. This may be a job she is taking due to the pandemic. So instead of being humble and accepting the generous tip she received, she's tripping. She's mad. She may come from a place where she makes extremely much more than that, but now she's been reduced to a respectable job. But it may be something that she's not used to because of what she used to be paid. I had a little story about that. It's funny. I was just speaking about this not too long ago, but I remember when I was looking for employment after I had lost a job. And the previous job, I was probably making upwards of 50K plus on a bad year. And so with that being said, the next job, well, it was actually a headhunter that sent me an opportunity for a position that paid $1,000 a month. And I felt so disrespected. I was definitely not going to humble myself for $1,000 a month. $2,000, we could have talked. But $1,000, he said he was starting up an insurance company, or I think it was like State Farm or one of those places where they gave him an office and he had to find people to work. And all he could pay at the moment was $1,000 to me to work full time. And I was like, hey, yeah, you got the wrong inbox. And then he called me and he proceeded to offer me $1,000 to work, and with the potential of possibly in the future making more money or getting a pay increase. And I was like, yeah, dog, that is not going to work on me. I'd rather collect unemployment, which I did, and I was just wasn't going to work for $1,000 a month. Now, during that time, things like DoorDash and so forth weren't the hot jobs to jump into, because I definitely would have taken up a DoorDash. See, like an $8 tip to me for, let's do the math. If it's 11 minutes, which I more so believe it was after looking at the math, $8 for 11 minutes, for 20 minutes in general, if it was 20, it's a nice little, I take that. That adds up. To whereas, even at 40 minutes, I mean, hey, if that's the amount I'm getting for this one, or hopefully on the next drive, maybe the next drive is only a 5-minute drive, and someone decides to tip me 10. There's certain things, like I said, I would humble myself for, and maybe that's why she's not. Maybe she's, you know, she really, really said, fuck it, I'm taking a stand. And sometimes if you don't, close mouths don't get fed. Maybe she was expected different here. Now, the funniest part of it was her making the judgment call to say, okay, you know what? I'm just going to take this money back. Now, she decided to do that. Take this food back. Now, she decided to do that after my man just had to ask her, what the hell are you looking for? Obviously, more money, fam. And in a customer service situation, no one is entitled to a tip, right? The service industry, you take the risk of being stiffed on a tip every day. Pause. And like, you have to just eat that. Like, you can't just, and obviously you can't just take the food back. I mean, there has to be some type of repercussions. And I don't know, maybe she was willing to take that risk. She said, forget it. Hey, it is what it is. But I think the man might have saved himself, because as I looked at her face in that Ring camera, shout out to Ring. Man, they capture everything. Ring. Actually has a video of my dad falling that could be on America's Funniest Home Videos. I wouldn't put them out there like that, but it's crazy. Crazy. But yeah, anyway. I looked at her face through that Ring camera, and one thing I saw was that she just wasn't wearing a mask at all. Now, I know a lot of people frown upon the wearing a mask while in the car, but if you have my food in your vehicle with you, I would just, even though I don't know exactly where it came from, the hands that prepared it, it just wouldn't give me some type of comfort knowing that, like, maybe everyone who has been around this food has been masked up. Maybe they were wearing gloves. This would give me some type of, or they made sure their hands were sanitized. And this gives me some type of comfort. But when the first person I see that is bringing my food to me is not wearing a mask, and she wants me to come out and talk to her face to face, she's maskless, I would have that was off rip. I'd like, no, I'm good. I don't need any of that food. Give me my refund. I'll figure it out another way. That's just what I would have been on. We wouldn't have had a long conversation. I'm like, all right, step the hell off my porch and take the food back with you. That's cool. If $8 ain't enough, I'll find someone else that will get it, bring it over here for $8. Bye. Have a good day. Bye. Bye. We wouldn't have been talking long. It just would have been bye. 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 I'm not about to beg for my food that I've already paid for. Bye. 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 But, yeah, man. Yeah, she gets it. We can add her to the Karen list. We'll add her there. Honorary Karen. That's what she'll be. She's not honorary Karen. You know, I hate giving them, like, cute nicknames for goofy shit that they do. Yeah. It is what it is. Yeah. That's all I got for y'all today, man. I don't really think I got any much of anything. I haven't seen that. I was gonna talk about Wonder Woman, but I didn't watch it. Heard it was garbage. I don't think anyone could convince me any otherwise. That's why I didn't watch the first one. Started off, wasn't really into it. Actually, kind of was looking at the second one for a second. Was like, okay, this might have potential. I didn't finish out the first few scenes. She was in like some little race or whatever, and I was like, oh, this is kind of dope. And then like someone else was watching, and I was just watching little parts, hearing little parts here and there, and I was just like, ugh, I don't want to watch this movie. Like, is niggas wishing for their powers? Like, I'm good. There's a lot of other shit you can wish for. But yeah, anyway, this has been another Makings Minute. I will be back later in the week. Let me see. I might clean up more so for the next one, but appreciate the people that always tune in and check your boy out. Love y'all, man. Fuck with y'all. Happy.